hair and beauty industry in Kenya is one of the biggest and fastest growing fields. A lot of young Kenyans and elderly Kenyans are staking claim in this territory. And it takes a lot of talent and skill to make it to the top, but it calls for perseverance, dedication, self-discipline, and a whole lot of sacrifice to stay at the top. And today we live out loud with two of Kenya's finest hairdressers, celebrity stylist Jayne Akoth and Liz Ngote, on what it took to live and everything they've learned. Hi, Jayne.
Hi.
Hi, Lizzie.
Hi, Sheila.
Thank you for making time to sit here with me today. We're going to live out loud together. And Jayne, you've got an incredible story. So tell us a little bit about yourself.
I'm born and raised up in Madare, Mlango Kubwa. I'm the fifth born in our family. So me born in Madare, I was a talented breeder at the age of 8. After my form 4, I got my first baby, who is now 18 years old. I'm 38, by the way.
Wow. And yeah. It doesn't show. You look so young and fresh and new.
Yeah, I think it's the genes.
Very good ones, yeah. Too.
So when I was at Madare, I got a small, it's like a kiosk. It was 300 bob per month. So I used to braid hair at 30 shillings, 20 shillings, the lines and the cornrows. So it was fun for me. It started as a fun because that is the only thing I could get. And at school, I remember I was very bright, especially in mathematics. My father used to like me because of mathematics, and I was very sporty too. But my talent, they never see it going anywhere. So I got so many discouragement, especially from my mother. My mother believed in education. And at least my father believed in the talents.
And that's the thing. When you're young and you're doing something that you like, You don't think of it as an occupation.
You didn't stop
to think, hey, here, I'm making something that can support me and help my family.
No.
And it's, I'm going to take a break with you because I want to find out about Liz's story as well, because there's some similarities in your journey. Mm-hmm. And so, Liz, for you, was it as difficult coming up and growing up as it was for Jayne?
I grew up in Buruburu. We had all the luxury. Went to good schools. I went to Riverbank before I was taken to Mukumu. Now, when I went to Mukumu Girls Primary Boarding, that is when I honed my skills. That is when I started plaiting. I used to plait my schoolmates, and they pay me. Those days, I was being paid one bob.
for cornrows
or wale wenye, those that didn't have the cash, they'd say, Liz, let me buy for you a slice of bread.
And bread is a big deal, whether you're in primary, whether you're in secondary school, it's everything.
Yeah, that was in the 80s, so that is how I used to hone my skills. During Saturday and Sunday, I was fully booked. I used to make cornrows, the milazzo style, you know. And then
not
I continue.
Kamatanas, you know, I know kamatanas because that's what my mom used to do on my head.
Yeah, those days the moms used to do kamatanas, but mostly I used to do the milazzos.
Right.
So I loved doing that. In high school, I used to make even the teachers and the headmistress. That is how I continued. When I cleared fourth form from Davadi Girls, I didn't go to hairdressing school. I went to graphics. I'm a graphic designer professionally. When I cleared college, I started tamaking. I was getting depressed. After that, I decided, let me try hairdressing.
Okay.
And then an uncle offered me some cash. I opened my own business in Komarok Estate, and I ran it for the last 10 years. Eh?
Right.
But it reached a point where I was so depressed, tired, I'm not growing, doing the same thing I go to YouTube, I see this vavavoom hairstyles, like in a Beyonce hairstyles. And then one day I was looking in the newspaper. I saw Jayne. She had the signature look, black and red hair. I was like, hey, is this Kenya? And then that is when I started stalking Jayne in newspapers.
Right.
I'm there. Then one day when I was busy cleaning my salon in the estate, I watched TV and then I saw Jayne there. I called in. We spoke. She said, yeah, come, I can mentor you. Then I was, are you serious? She was like, yeah. I was so emotional that day I cried. And then the next day on Monday, I was at Jayne's by 7 a.m.
All right. Now, before we talk about what happened next, because here you are stalking Jayne and having the offer from Jayne to be mentored by Jayne, it called for sacrifice from you. And before we talk about that sacrifice, I go back to your story because you've just set up shop. Here you are braiding and doing little lines and having fun with what you're doing. But that was way before you could even mentor Liz. So what happened next in your growth?
When I was in my small shop, I used to encourage so many people to do like braiding because it was just an inborn talent. There I met Mr. Farouk Jenedi. Somebody I did her hair. Farouk saw her hair. And then Farouk asked the lady if she can call me. When I went to Farouk, and then he said he'll mentor me, he'll put me under his wings. I was very naive. I didn't know what to say, what to do. But because I was seeing these strange hairstyles, clients, big clients, so I was like, how will I fit in here? But Farouk had, I remember him calling me my genius. So I felt like, oh my God, am I a genius? In which category? Because I've never told him that how I passed my exam or my story, but he used to see the talent in me. And everywhere I remember him telling me, Jayne, you'll go very far. I remember the first time I went to America and I came back, he asked me the first question, do you know now your value when you went to America? Do you know your value? When he wrote that letter when I was going to the embassy, I was like, wow, this letter is so nice. Will I ever come back? It's too nice to come back to Kenya.
And most Kenyans are dying to cross the border and go start a life
out
there.
But when I went there, they were shocked the way I was doing my job because I didn't know they would be shocked. But it's because Farouk had already trained me so much how to do hair, how to put weaves, branded me. In fact, I remember Farouk telling me, you are not a braider anymore. You are a celebrity stylist.
Is that where the name was birthed?
Yeah.
Jayne, celebrity stylist.
So every time he said, make sure they Google you. Celebrity stylist in Kenya.
But you've mentioned something about going to America. Why did you come back? Because we know people want to go and never come back. Or we won't know that people go to start new lives there and they think that it's going to be better than, you know, setting up shop
one
here.
One of the major reasons, the way Farouk treated me, I felt like a baby under his wing. So, and then I felt like the empowerment that he gave me was more than how I will feel the other side. And another thing, I already had my son. And my son was by that time around 10 years. So I was like, why should I go and leave my son alone? And I'm somebody who loved my son so much.
Right. Yeah. Now going back to your story, Liz, here you are, you've watched Jayne and you're in your little shop in Comarock and you understand that you need to get to the next level and the person who's going to help you get to that next level is Jayne. Of that you were sure. But it meant that you would have to do something very difficult. Tell us about that.
So when I called Jayne and then we started the journey of mentoring, we met in 2013, June, and then we started the journey. I'd go for her classes, go back to my salon. I'm like, really? I'm learning this stuff and I'm charging this much. It's not adding up. And when you tell the clients of Mutaani, I'm going for classes, they're happy. But ukiambia, charge. And I'm like, no, that is so expensive. Why are you? And then I decided, no. I started praying, asking God, now, what next? Then when I came to see Jayne, was it in December 2013? She told me, Jayne, Liz, there's something I want to show you. I was like, okay. We went, there was a building that we entered and she told me, hey, unonaje place. I was like, this is a nice one. It's very warm, it's welcoming. Then she did her hair there. We sat, we talked, and then we left. While we were walking, she was like, Liz, I want to open this place and I want you to come and work with me. I was like, are you serious? Yeah, but it's you to decide. I went home. Because I was praying and fasting. December 31st, that is when the answer came. I closed shop. That was my baby for 10 years. It was so emotional. I cried. But I had to grow. You see, then I moved. Then we met with Jayne. We decided, now we started the journey.
Jayne, you've had support. You've had a lot of influences that have helped you get to where you are? Yes, when you expected your family to support you and encourage you, they laughed about this skill that you had because they didn't quite see what you saw. But it hasn't always been rosy. And I understand what it's like to go through things in the workplace and get fired, not necessarily because you don't know what you're doing, but simply because it's time for you to step up and move on to something greater. Tell us about your experience.
Sheila, let me tell you, you know, when you get fired, you are in shock first because you don't believe. Like you see, for our industry, I was there for like 12 years in the same place. So when I got this letter, it was a 2 hours notice. So I was told, I was given a letter at around 3. By 5, I had to vacate. Then it didn't sink in. So I was supposed to sign that letter immediately, or else it will be told, it will be treated as a trespass when I go back there. For like a week, I was still in shock. I didn't know what to do. I remember telling one of my clients, she told me, good for you, you are fired. I'm like, why are you telling me that? And then she told me, I told you long time ago, you should have opened your salon. You are a brand. I'm like, how am I a brand? You know, from this humble beginning, from Madare and going to Westlands, I still didn't realize that I'm a brand of my own.
Right. And a lot of people, when that work ends, they look at it as a curse, that how could you deny me this? But really, it's the beginning of another opportunity.
For me, it's the beginning. And for me, what I can say, it was 2014. And I had just won an award for weaving of the year. And I was the best hairdresser for that year on the competition. It was a live competition. And from that experience, I'm able to counsel so many people who are undergoing the same thing. And all my clients who have been fired within those 2 years, by now they don't even take 6 months. By after 1 month, they are already on their feet.
There's something
moving.
Different happening.
Yeah. And the mentorship I give them, they come back after 2 weeks or 3 weeks. Jayne, thank you so much. Thank you so much. I'm like, thanks God I passed through that. I had to pass through that so that I can help other people.
All right. Far too often, people don't treat hairdressers and stylists with respect. You know, that occupation of hair and beauty is considered something to do, but it's a truly, fully legit business, isn't it, Jayne?
I have this guy called Jemo. Jemo got an A in maths, A in biology, A in chemistry, a mini grade of B plus. Sometimes when I talk, he understands my language. When you get this person who is learned, it works faster for us. And we get this person who is just an artist and is not maybe learned, it doesn't work for us. Hairdressing is not for dunderheads. It's just a career like any other career, like a lawyer, like any other investor, running hotels and all that. It's just a career like any other career.
In closing, I'd like you to inspire people who would like to do what you do, because it's taken time to get to where you are. Nothing good is ever given to you on a plate, and it happens overnight. It's work, it's dedication, it's sacrifice. So Liz, what would you like to say to somebody who's looking and thinking, I want to be like her, I want to walk her journey, and I'm ready to sacrifice everything to get there?
If you're passionate about it, just go for it. That is all I tell people, because I decided and I went for it. I took a risk. I left my business for 10 years, and I took a leap of faith. I said, if I go there and fail, so what? I'm working with my talent. So go for it. Don't be afraid of anything. Just go for it.
What about you, Jayne?
Every time you mentor other people, you need also to have a mentor so that you can be refilled. Never be jealous of mentoring other people, because like in my industry, it's all about clients. So I get a lot of salon owners and other people, they don't mentor because they say the hairdresser will run away with the client. As long as you work under my place, there's one thing I say. I want, when this person leaves my place, she has something to remember about Jayne.
Thank you very much, ladies, for making the time to inspire and share your beautiful stories with us.
Thank you.
We'll
thank you,
see
Sheila.
You soon, without doubt. I'm Sheila Mwanyega at Westwood Hotel. Just about to sign off, but before I do, got to remind you that we are looking for you and your stories of empowerment, inspiration. It could be your story, or it could be another story that you believe needs to be told. If you've got one of those, please get in touch with us. Take a look at all those social media sites. Tuma the email. Yes, we're definitely going to get back to you. But for now, it's live out loud in everything that you do.